So my story is I was a former domestic worker in Hong Kong for almost a decade until I got discovered by Rico Camora on Facebook. So social media did a lot for me. It started from there. I won the Magnum Human Rights Fellowship, and then I was able to change my life in so many ways. I did a story about how education can actually bridge a gap between two sides who's been in conflict for the longest time, and also to battle Islamophobia, about changing the mindset of people that not all Muslims are terrorists. I think social media is really huge nowadays. It's supposed to connect us, but what is happening is it's dividing us. It's because people nowadays are not listening. If someone is not agreeing to your opinion, they will judge you and call you biased. They will call you bigot, racist, or any bad words that they can call you just because they don't agree with your opinion. And we don't realize that with this kind of very shallow conversation, we're dividing the society. I'm hoping that we use social media in a way na mas productive siya, mas maging way of unity siya, to unite us rather than divide us. Lahat ng tao may pinagdadaanan. Kaya ganun ang opinion. So makinig tayo, tanungin natin kung bakit. Hindi yung i-judge mo siya na stupid ka kasi, kaya ganyang paniniwala mo eh, diba? Mas maganda kung mag-uusap tayo ng nagkakarinigan, nagkakaintindihan. Hindi yung nag-uusap tayo ng nagsisigawan mo. I think the worst part, the saddest part about having a conversation is not being able to communicate yourself clearly and listen to the other part. I always believe that everyone got a story. Always, para sa akin, ang responsibility ko is, because they allowed me into their lives, right? Is to share their stories because they wanted to be heard.